Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Miss Lanna's Chocolate Chip Bundt Cake. Now Miss Lanna is a viewer that I have on YouTube, and she sent me this recipe a long time ago, maybe a year ago. And I've always intended to make it and just never gotten around to it because there was always some other dessert that I was trying to work in. But this sounds delicious, and it's more than just a chocolate chip bundt cake. You'll find that there are some very interesting ingredients in it, and I think you'll enjoy seeing it put together, and you may want to make it. By the way, Miss Lanna, I don't have your last name, so if you would like to have your last name and this credited to you in Betty's Kitchen, just put a comment below or send me a private message and I'll add your last name. But I want to thank you ahead of time for the wonderful recipe. We start out with a large bowl, and into that bowl we're going to put a yellow cake mix. And this just says traditional yellow, and it's 15.25 ounces, so just something similar to that. It doesn't have to be this brand. It can be a store brand or generic. Anything you want to use. In fact, it doesn't actually have to be a yellow cake. It could be a white cake, or you can find pineapple cakes and something that's similar to this. Now I have a 3.4 ounce package of coconut cream pudding. And I'm holding this so it won't fall out right now, but I've opened the top so I can pour that in. This is the small package. It is instant pudding, and it does contain the sugar, so it's not artificially sweetened. You may use the artificially sweetened, but since this cake has a lot of goodies in it that are sweet or fat, it's not a diet cake. So I'm not trying to make it sound like that by picking one item and making it lower in calorie. Next comes applesauce. So we have this little container, which is a half cup. So you can just use a snack pack, or if you have a larger jar or something, measure out one half cup. Next is one half cup water. And then we have three whole eggs. Now I'm going to turn on my electric mixer, and I'm going to be beating this for 2 minutes on medium speed. After beating this mixture for 2 minutes, you need to scrape down the sides, and probably during the beating, if you will scrape down the sides, it'll be better. But this should be a mixture that is fairly free of lumps. And we're ready to move on, and we're going to fold in a few items. First comes sour cream. So this is 8 ounces of sour cream. Got it? So we have Heath bar, which has been chopped up, and actually I didn't take the time to chop them up myself. So these are just bits of brickle. There's no chocolate on them, and they're very finely chopped. But you may choose what you want to do here. In Miss Lanna's version, she said you could use chocolate bars, Hershey bars, and chop them fine and put them in a measuring cup and get 3/4 cup. So either the Heath bar or a Hershey bar, 3/4 cup chopped up. Next comes semi-sweet chocolate chips, 1 cup. And the last ingredient before we stir is 1 cup of pecan pieces. And stir. Once you have everything stirred together like this, you're going to place it in a bundt cake pan. Now here's my bundt cake pan, and I have buttered it very liberally. Actually, mine didn't need it so much because it has a nonstick coating, but I wanted to demonstrate it in the way it was written up, and Miss Lanna said to butter it very well. So it's just butter that has been rubbed around. Now we're going to use a large spoon and dip this out until we get all of it. And then we will level off the top and we'll be ready to take this to the oven. So here we have our cake batter in our Bundt cake pan, and I usually shake it back and forth a little, up and down, trying to get any air bubbles out. If they are not gotten out, then as it rises, the bubble may stay and it just creates a hole, which is not very attractive. It doesn't affect the taste, but you want it to look as attractive as possible. This goes to a 350 degree oven, and it bakes for approximately 1 hour. I'm not gonna say it's 50, 55, 60, 65 minutes, but I'll be testing with a cake tester, and when the cake tester comes out clean, or you can use a knife and go down in it at the deepest point with a knife, and if it comes out clean, then it's done. So we'll be getting it out as soon as it's done. Our cake is just out of the oven, and in my oven, it was done after 45 minutes. And here's what it looks like. It's nice and golden, sort of going to brown around the edges. And when I used a cake tester in it, it came out clean. If you use a knife, then it should come out like that. You do want to take your knife and go around the center so that this will release properly, and also go around the edges. This is very warm, even hot, because it's only been out a few minutes. It's been out long enough for it to shrink away from the sides a little bit, so you might want to give it a chance to do that, and that will be helpful to you in getting it out of the pan. One way you can decorate it is to sprinkle some confectioner's sugar over the top, and I think that's what I'm going to do here. And if you have any flaws, like where that's stuck a little bit, you can just put an extra amount of confectioner's sugar, and there's no problem whatsoever. So this is looking really pretty, just like snowflakes on top of the cake. And that's what you want it to look like. Straighten it up a little bit, and it's ready to go. The thing is, it's very hot right now, and it's very warm. So I would suggest, well, Miss Lanna suggested that you cover it while it's cooling. So you might use some plastic wrap or some aluminum foil. If you plan to take this somewhere, then you can put it in a Tupperware that is intended for a cake. So I've already checked, and I think this fits well. So we can just put it right there and then put the lid on and tighten it up. And there it is, ready to go. Now, Miss Lanna said that as far as the taste, it tastes best when it's right out of the oven, when it's hot or warm. Or you can leave it to soak in all those flavors by all these coverings that we've talked about putting on it. And the next day, after it's been in the refrigerator, it will taste really good. So I'm going to take my taste now. So I'm going to clean up the counter a little bit, and I'll be back to take the taste. I've taken a knife and made one cut here and one cut here. And I'm going to go under that with a pie server or cake server and bring it out. It's very warm. And you can see what it looks like. It's easy to handle because it is done all the way through. And we're going to put it on a plate and get ready to take a bite. Well, I have my coffee ready, and I can't wait for this bite. I've not tried this cake before, but since it was so highly recommended by Miss Lanna, I thought it would be good. And reading through it, all the ingredients are just things I love, so I have to love it. So let's get some of this over here. I want to definitely get some filling And you'll see it's kind of gooey where the chocolate has melted. But there are a lot of things in there. So I want to taste a little applesauce as well as bits of brickle. And the cake itself, that's so good. Gotta go back for some more. Oh, that was such a good taste. It's just wonderful. I would like to say to Miss Lanna, I'm sorry it has taken me so long to get around to making this cake, because it's just as good as you said, maybe even better. I can't imagine putting ingredients together that go better with one another. The taste is wonderful. It's something that you can transport easily, as I said, and you can serve it hot or you can serve it chilled. But it's just a great idea. Thanks, Miss Lanna.